The German army had been expressly ordered to behave themselves on the Channel Islands, and we know that the situation would have been the same in occupied Britain. The evidence is a document called The Guide for Troops in Occupied England, written by Field Marshal Walter von Prauschitz in July 1940.
A firm and cautious attitude towards the civilian population is to be adopted. The death sentence may be imposed for acts of violence against orderly members of the population or for looting. Any private purchases by individual soldiers are to be paid for in cash. The rate of exchange will be one English pound for 9.6 Reichsmark.
But this was just the beginning of Hitler's plans for Britain.
November 4th, 1940. Sporadic fighting continues around the government stronghold in Worcester, but in London a strange calm reigns over the city. Marshal von Brauchitz's well-disciplined troops have spent the last 2 weeks clearing up the capital, and British shopkeepers are making record profits. It seems as if the Nazis are trying to charm the British into submission.
But charm was just the first part of von Brauchitz's strategy. As well as his guide for troops in Britain, in July 1940, he issued the most secret directive for the military government in England. This document outlined the second part of his strategy. Behind the velvet glove lay an iron fist.
November 5th, 1940. Field Marshal Walter von Brauchitz, military commander of Great Britain, orders the deportation of almost 2 million prisoners of war to camps on the continent. Whilst wives, mothers and children weep, the men are taken to specially prepared camps outside Paris, where they will remain as hostages for the duration of the war.
Why was this going to be done? Well, I think one has to look at the situation in occupied France, fallen the month before. Because there, nearly 2 million men of roughly between those ages had been placed in prisoner of war camps in Germany. And their sort of treatment could be used as a lever. Play along with us and the prisoners will receive good treatment. Don't do what we say, don't collaborate, and the prisoners will suffer.
November 18th. Dr. Franz Six arrives in London. He is accompanied by the elite Einsatzkommandos England. This is the secret Nazi death squad assigned to Great Britain. Over the next 2 weeks, they will kill more than 2,000 people in an operation that Dr. Six has been planning for more than 3 months.
Dr. Franz Six was typical of the sort of people that ran these task forces, in the sense that he was a sort of ex-hack journalist who'd somehow or other, because of his politics, managed to become a professor at a good university, but even that wasn't enough for him. So he's a sort of typical demi-educated graduate, and these people were utterly ruthless and without scruple. And had he, judging by what his colleagues did in other countries, I mean, the slightest provocation, he would have been let loose on parts of the British population and would have done God knows what.
Dr. Franz Six had been a fervent Nazi since 1933 and had used his connections to obtain a high-ranking position at Berlin's university. Here, he used his pseudo-academic credentials to justify the Nazi policy of eliminating their enemies. Having proved his loyalty, in July 1940, Dr. Six was appointed as the higher police leader for Great Britain. His orders came directly from Reinhard Heydrich, head of the German security service. Nicknamed the Blonde Beast by the Nazis, Heydrich was the most feared man in occupied Europe, and these were his instructions.
Your task is to combat all anti-German organizations, institutions, and opposition groups in England.
Dr. Six immediately began assembling his team. The documents he wrote have now been translated for the first time, and they paint a terrifying picture of his plans for Britain. In this file, he describes precisely how his elite death squad would operate. Six intended to set up his headquarters in London. The cities of Manchester, Liverpool, Birmingham, and Bristol would each have their own task force. Dr. Six even assigned specialists to handle different groups such as Freemasons, Marxists, liberals, and Jews. Dr. Six spent almost a month training his team of murderers at a secret location. On August 8, 1940, he wrote this letter to Heydrich.
Gruppenführer, the preparations for the Einsatzgruppe for England are complete. Classes in practical English have been given and have been rounded off with a few hours of pistol and machine gun shooting. Signed, Dr. Six.
It's very interesting that there was a task force, one of the Einsatzgruppen, formed and assigned to deal with England, because one knows what they did when similar units were followed the troops into Poland in September 1939. They did round up large numbers of people who they thought were the social elite, and they murdered them. They just, you know, took them out to a forest or something and shot them down.
Anticipating that his workload in Britain would be very high, Six commissioned these signs 3 months before Operation Sea Lion was due to take place.
November 20th. Dr. Franz Six and his death squad commandeer the Dorchester Hotel. Over the coming months, Suite 513 will acquire a notorious reputation. From their new headquarters, the Einsatzkommandos begin their reign of terror. On the first day of operations, 44 prominent Londoners are dragged from their homes. Amongst them is the entertainer and playwright Noel Coward, who dies whilst being interrogated. He was number C96 in the Nazi special search list, otherwise known as the Black Book.
One of our great prize exhibits at the museum is the Black Book, the special arrest list that was produced by the security service of the SS, which lists thousands of people in this country that were going to be arrested if the Germans had successfully invaded this country.
Of the 20,000 copies of this book that were originally printed, only two remain in existence. The Sunder van Dungus List, GB, or Black Book, named 2,820 individual enemies of the Reich, who were to be hunted down and eliminated once Britain had been occupied. All the members of the British government and the civil service were on the list, as well as various European emigres who had fled Nazi persecution. But the remainder were the cream of Britain's intellectual and literary elite. With Teutonic efficiency, the Nazis would have worked their way down the list in alphabetical order.
November 22, 1940. Dr. Franz Six's reign of terror continues. E.M. Forster, author of A Passage to India, is arrested on charges of homosexuality and deported to Germany. Outspoken socialist and science fiction writer H.G. Wells is fatally wounded trying to escape the Gestapo. Bohemian novelist Virginia Woolf drowns herself rather than face interrogation by the Nazis.